All right, hello, my name is Frank Bissell. I'm the owner of Piano Organ Depot, and today we're going to be looking at the app for the Disklavier Enspire Piano. Before you can use this app, you've got to go into your network settings, and in this case, these are my networks, and you want to go to the Disklavier wireless network that it generates, and then you'll be able to open the app. Now, if you have a iPad or an iPhone, you go to the App Store, download it, and just open it once you're connected. But if you're using a Mac computer or a laptop computer, you want to type in 192.168.88.1. See it right up here. You want to type that into the browser and hit enter, and that will bring up the app that you're going to use. This is the Disklavier Enspire app. Now, it's got 500 built-in songs, and these are some of the songs, and we're going to look at some of the playlists. Like, you could set up a playlist. Now, right out of the box, they give you a playlist that they develop, but you could turn around and go to any song that one of the 500 songs, or your own personal library of songs, and you can set up a playlist yourself. So here's, we'll just click on one of the songs. This is song. All right.
I hold you in the dark and wait for the spark that once was between us. Love.
Now again, 500 songs. Not only 500 built-in songs, but you actually have 9,000 songs that you can purchase through Yamaha PianoSoft site. You also can download just a tremendous amount of songs from other sites that are third-party sites. This is just like a regular recording. I could even fast forward it. You got a volume control. Turn it softer. Turn it louder. You're in the living room. You have company. You could turn it whisper soft. Or use it in a restaurant. You look at the library of songs. You have pop music, rock music, jazz, R&B, classical. These are all your classical songs. Again, like I said, 500 built-in songs for free. Some holiday songs. Now, you could also shop for other music. You go to music shop here. There's shop now. You click on that, and that'll take you to the PianoSoft or MusicSoft library. And here's a song here. Here's a few songs that you can download. Christmas songs. Just thousands, like I said, 9,000 different songs. Trying to do a search, you just enter the name of the song in the search bar. Now, not only that, but you can go to third-party sites. This is a site here, musicalarchives.com. They have over 10,000 MIDI songs. So you want a MIDI file, and the Disklavier will play any general MIDI file. And in this case, I downloaded for free this song right here. It's a Chopin etude. Let's go back here. So here's the thing. I'm going to turn this down. I'll talk while it's playing. Now here's the thing that you can go into your songs and there's a feature here called PC sharing folder, PC sharing folder. And if you click on that, that'll bring you to a folder that's networked to the piano. Right now it's going to a thumb drive, and these are all songs. This is one I got from Classical Archives. This is one that I wrote. That's another thing. If you have a friend that plays, you play. You could record your own music. And this is especially great for people that are vocalists, or maybe you play another instrument, maybe you play guitar or trumpet, sax, and you don't play piano very well. You could bring a friend in, and that friend can play the accompaniment. You could have it in your library, and you want to play your sax, or you could sing along with it. You could do a singspiration. All right, let's go here. I'm going to turn this off. And these are, again, I'm looking here at my song list. These are PC sharing. In other words, I downloaded them on my PC, and I put them in this folder. Here's one that I wrote, and I recorded on the Disklavier. And actually, I have another video showing how I wrote this song on the Disklavier using Yamaha's new notation software called Dorico, and I orchestrated it with Cubase. But here we have a song that I wrote. And you can look at that video if you want, you're interested in seeing how I wrote this song and the process of using the Disklavier as a songwriter. One that I wrote, but let's go back. Here's one here that I actually did this for my music recital, my senior recital. I couldn't play it possibly. I had to practice for 6 months to learn it. And one of the hardest piano pieces ever written, Rachmaninoff piece. I tell you what, years ago, I would have loved to have this technology because we had to do music minus one back then, and you had this annoying click in your ear that you needed to use to keep in time with the music, and I forgot to put the ear plug in when I did this, and I messed up the whole introduction. And about this part right here, I put the ear plug back in. All right, let's go back. Here's a jazz piece here. Again, this is free. Downloaded it on the internet. I have probably over 3,000 or 4,000 songs that I've downloaded through the years. I've been doing this a long time. And when you buy this instrument from us, I'd be glad to share my library with you and give it to you for free. But anyway, this is these weren't purchased. They were free. This is one here. I'll show you this. I got this. I just downloaded it today for this demo. This is the one on my desktop right over here. See it? There it is. Put that over there, and I just dragged it in there. And let's see what that sounds like. That's a Chopin piece. Again, got it for free. Show you maybe in the background here how I downloaded it, drug it into the folder, refreshed the folder, and then it came right up. Now this is amazing technology. This is called MIDI, Musical Instrument Digital Interface. All right, let's go back. Again, these are all songs. We go back to our song library. Now the playlist is very handy. Playlist is very handy because you could have one playlist with just holiday music, one playlist with just piano music, one playlist with vocal music. Now let me show you something here. When you go into your songs, go into the songs. Let's go into one of the pop songs. You see where it says audio? Wherever you see audio, that means there's an audio file. Where you ever see plus, that means it's a MIDI file. There might be MIDI instruments that are being played with it. Solo means it's just piano. Let's demo this. All right, this one's going to have some audio. All right. Sold one of these years ago to a fellow. We were in a mall, and he was coming through. I think he looked at the piano for 6 months straight, and his son, who was in partnership with him, came over one day and said, "My dad's been looking at this piano for 6 months, and he's too cheap to buy it for himself," he said. "How much is it?" I told him how much. He said, "I'm going to buy it for my dad." And then he bought it. And then he said, and the wife said, "You know, honey, we have a piano just sitting there. It would be nice for us to have one of these too." So they bought two of them, one for them and one for their dad. And I made him but back then they made CDs. And now it's USB drives or thumb drives. And I made him a file with just all classical music. He said he loved classical music. All he wanted was a library of classical music. And so I gave him a file, and he just wanted to play. He don't play. He just wanted to be able to listen to classical music. Look over here if you like classical music. Here's the whole library of classical music. And we'll find one with some audio. Okay. Here we go. Well, he was in his glory. When we put that in his house, he just used to sit there and put it on quietly in the background as he read. What a joy it is to bring some happiness into people's lives through music. Now, I'll show you another feature. I'll turn this down. I'll talk about playing. I can't possibly play 500 songs, but here's another thing. This is a great instrument for a teacher. You can record your students' lesson and give them a thumb drive with the audio file of their progress. I have one teacher that bought an instrument from me, and what she does is she keeps a record of the advancement of her students and records their lessons. What she'll do is she'll give them a piece of music, and then when they're ready, they perform it, and she records it and keeps a record of it. And this is almost like their recital. So every lesson that she has almost is like a recital, and that's so exciting for kids. All right, if you go over here to your built-in songs, Yamaha gives you a book called 50 Greats for the Piano. And here's one, of course, the Bach invention. Or not Bach, I'm sorry. The invention number one. Very famous piece that every piano student has to learn. But here's one of the things you could do with this. You can turn around and, when I hit that icon, that, let's see if I could get it back. Let's do it again. There you go, over your built-in songs. You go into your 50 greats. All right. Now, you put the Bach invention on. Now, you see this little icon here? All right, what that is, that icon will bring up, see over here? It'll bring up another menu. And here, you could transpose that piece. You can actually slow it down. Maybe let's take this one here. Let's say you're learning this piece. You could slow it down. Then you could turn around, and of course, this music, these are classics, so whatever publisher you get this song from, it'll follow this perfectly. Now, you go over here, let's say you want to learn the right or the left hand. You can turn the left hand off and just focus in on the right hand. Let's say you want to learn the left hand. Turn the right hand off and just focus in on the left. And then many times it's good to turn the pedal off, because that'll confuse students. They could learn the pedal. And I don't know if you've been noticing how the Yamaha Disklavier pedal function works. It's great. Actually, the pedals actually move just as if somebody's there playing them. Okay. Now these are 50 greats. Turn that off. Okay. Go back. Clair de Lune, that's a very famous piece of music that a lot of students learn. And again, you could learn the right hand, left hand, just the right hand. You turn the sustain pedal off. Learning the sustain pedal for many students is really a chore. And this way, this piano will actually teach students the proper way to play a sustain pedal. Put that back on. And now with something like Debussy, the sustain pedal is very important. I'll turn it off, you'll hear the difference. Watch. I'll turn it back on. So again, great teaching tool. There's 50, if you think about it, 50 greats for the piano. There are 50 lessons built into this, plus all the other lessons, the inventions, all the other things that we already showed you. Just a tremendous tool for teaching. And there's no company like Yamaha that has such great instruments for students and teachers and institutions. A lot of people say, well, what do I need a player piano for? Well, this is more than player piano. This is a teaching instrument. Years ago when I was paying $50 a lesson and maybe more, I had a teacher from Juilliard that was teaching me during my college years. I think I paid him $100 a lesson. One of the things, the first thing he did is he played the song as it should be. He played it like it should be, and then he started showing me how to play it. And that was such a great tool to hear the way it's supposed to be. And now here you got 50 songs plus all these others. Plus, you could go to classical archives. And these are classics. All these are classics. You can get the music for any of these, and these will follow the music exact. All right? And all right, go out of that. A minuet in G. Everybody knows that. At least heard it. Again, right hand off, left hand's on, right hand's on, turn the left hand off. Your 50 classics. These are all lessons. Amazing. Again, teaching tools. Then you also can record and play back. You got Disklavier radio. I don't have that hooked up. I'm sorry to say, I just don't have a wireless internet interface that I could hook up to it right here. Then, of course, you want to go shopping for music. You go to music shop, shop now, and I showed you that. And the rest are settings and songs. It's a great, great, great instrument. But in closing, you know, let's say you have a party at the house. You don't play the piano. You always wished you could. This is a piano, believe it or not, anybody could play. It's got a thing called Smart Key. You go to Smart Key, and these are all songs that the piano will teach you how to play at least the melody with this. Play the melody. You have a birthday party, everybody comes in, gather around the piano, and you can play Happy Birthday, even if you don't know how to play Happy Birthday. And we'll show you that, and then we'll close. Thank you so much for watching. Watch my other videos. We have a video where we show you how this piano can be hooked up with MIDI. I've been showing you a lot of this is MIDI. and can be hooked up, and you can expand this piano. You could add a workstation, a Yamaha workstation, and just some tremendous technology to inspire you to play. And again, appropriate name for this piano, Enspire. And we'll show you that on the next video. Make an appointment. I work by appointment because I tune pianos, we move pianos, we service pianos. We're always doing something, but we work by appointment. So give me a call, and I'd love to spend some time with you and show you our inventory and show you how this piano truly will inspire you to love music, to play music, to listen to music. All right, thank you very much, and hope you could visit with us sometime at our store.
Yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire, I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You've got to help me make a stand. Just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Oh, I've seen fire, I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Now I'm walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines and pieces on the ground. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. Oh, but I always thought that I'd see you again. Thought I'd see you one more time again. There's just a few things coming my way this time around now. Thought I'd see you, thought I'd see you.